All right. How's everybody doing? Cool. So, we are going to flow for about an hour today. So just a quick recap as to what you will need for class today. Okay. So you will need a couple of blocks. Now, if you don't have blocks, like I said in the previous weeks, you can use a book. I've been told Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire is a perfect yoga block substitute, but any kind of hardbound book is fine. If you have small trash cans, anything that can basically hold you up will work as a yoga block substitute. You need a strap. Now, a strap, perfect substitute for a strap is a belt. Drop that. A leather belt. Anything that's not gonna come apart if you pull on it will work. So belt, a rope of some kind, and also a blanket. So whatever kind of blanket you have, I have one of the like yoga blankets, but this dinosaur blanket I often use as well in my home practice. Always good. And new thing this week, because I just want to make sure that everybody is staying hydrated, bottle of water, glass of water. Want to make sure that we're hydrating. And also go to the bathroom when you need to, take breaks when you need to. Drink water when you need to. And yeah, so we are going to give everybody about a minute before we go, before we come in. We are gonna start off standing today. So if you wanna do any seated poses for warm-up or anything like that, go ahead and do that now. And then we're gonna start at 10:30. So, by the way, I'm Andre. I am a teacher with Roots to Rise. Roots to Rise is an organization that works to provide access to yoga to anybody that needs it. So, low cost, no cost yoga and meditations. We're online until we can be back in physical spaces. So, which means that we are accepting donations today. You can donate via Venmo at Roots to Rise, or you can donate through our website or our Facebook page. So I'm gonna put that there now so everybody knows. So if anybody has any questions, feel free to let me know while I can see. So, like I said, we're going to start in a standing position, what we call mountain pose. So if everybody just comes to standing, feet parallel, pointed forward. Arms by your sides. So we want to make sure that we are rooted in the four corners of our feet. So what we're going to do is we're going to stand hips width distance apart, and we're really going to press into our big toe ball mounds. Okay? And once you feel that, we're going to roll our feet out to press through our little toe ball mounds. Okay? Gotta back up so they can see on IG. Then we're going to press through our outer heel, the knife blade edge of our foot, and then our inner heel. So inside of our foot, pacing that way. Lift your toes up towards your face and really feel that. So whenever you stand, it's going to be important that you know that. So that's our roots. So whenever we stand, that's how we're standing. Okay? So as we bring our eyes to close, we bring our hands to heart center. Take a big breath in. Sigh it out. As we breathe in, this is my time to tell you that anything I offer you today in this class is simply that. It's an invitation. You don't have to do anything your body tells you it's not going to do today. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Take a big breath in. And as we exhale, we bring our arms out nice and wide, like we're holding a giant beach ball, like we're ready for whatever the world has to offer us today. Inhale, arms overhead, palms to touch. Exhale, flip the palms down. Bring them down by your sides. Now, for those of you like me, breathe in, that have a natural turnout, years of ballet, make sure that those feet are parallel and not turning out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. And in and out. As you take a big breath in, bring your arms overhead. Right hand clasped the left wrist as we stretch up, fingers towards the ceiling, and we stretch to the right. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. As we inhale to center, we switch clasps. We exhale as we switch, as we stretch to the left. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Bring it in, shake it out. As we just wake the body up today, come to the ball of your right foot, okay? And really root those, you know, the arch of the right foot into the mat, okay? And then really put some more weight into your left foot. And once you feel rooted, because that's the thing, you want to make sure that you're rooted in that left foot before you do anything. So then we're going to lift that right heel towards the right butt cheek. I'm going to bring the right shoulder up and back. I'm going to grab that ankle. Whoa. Squeeze your inner thighs together. Push that ankle into that hand into that ankle. If you're feeling a little unsteady, that's totally acceptable and fine. Because I am too this morning, apparently. Belly in towards the spine, shoulders on the back. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. You can bring that left bicep by the ear. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And release. Shake it out. Then we're coming to the ball of our left foot. Okay? Same thing. You want to put that weight. You want to really root really strong. You want to press down through your right foot into the mat. Okay? Now make sure you're doing that before you're leaving your feet. So then you're going to take that left heel, put it towards the left butt cheek, lift that left shoulder up and back, grab that ankle. Push that ankle to that hand, hand to that ankle. Standing thigh stretch. Then if you want to, you can raise that right bicep towards the right ear. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. Whoa. And release. Shake it out. 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 All right. So take your belt. Take your strap. So you want to put that behind you, bending those elbows back slightly, right? And then we're going to heel toe our feet to the outside of our mat until we get wide with our legs. And then we're going to put our shoulders on our back and press our fists down towards the mat to give a nice opening in the chest. We can bring our head up towards the ceiling. Take a big breath in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to go for that big forward fold. Chest opener. Keep those elbows bent. Pull that belt, that strap apart. Breathe in and out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. You can lose the strap. Bring your hands to the mat. Wide-legged forward fold. Breathe in. And out. In. And out. In. And out, in, and out. Take a big breath in as we walk our hands over to the right. You can grab that ankle if you wish. You can bring your fingertips to the floor. You can bring them to one of your blocks or your books. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. And in and out. Bring it into the center. Big breath in. Big breath out. Bring your lips to touch. Breathe in through the nose.
and out through the nose. In through the nose. Out through the nose. In through the nose. And as we breathe out, we walk our hands over to the left. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. As we come to the center, we come up halfway. We exhale, we fold deeper. And as we inhale, vertebrae by vertebrae, we come up and heel to our feet. Back to hips width distance apart. Stand strong, mountain pose. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold, hands to the mat. Breathe in. Exhale as we come to our hands and knees. Shoulders under wrists, knees under hips. As we inhale, we drop our belly, raise our head towards the ceiling. Cow pose. As we exhale, bring our head towards our heart, arch our spine. Cat pose. Inhale for cow pose. Exhale for cat pose. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. We come up. Take a big breath in. And then we send that left leg back. Breathe in. Send your sitting bones towards your heels. As you exhale, the right arm forward. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. Out. Breathe in. Out. In. And out. We inhale. Bring that left leg up hip height. Make sure the toes are dialed down towards the mat. Make sure your hips are square. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. Out. In. Out. In. And out. Now we're holding that for just 1 second. We're gonna hold that extended table. Breathe in, and as we exhale, bringing that right arm to the right, that left leg to the left. We inhale, we bring it to center. Exhale, rep. Inhale, bring it to the side. Exhale, we bring it to the center. Two more, inhale. Breathe in, exhale, bring it down, shake it out. Take a big breath in, extend that right leg back. Inhale brings the left arm forward. Breathe in, and out. Breathe in, and Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale brings that left leg hip height. Want to make sure it's hip height, okay? We don't want it to be too high. Toes dialed down towards the mat. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Pull your belly in towards the spine. Breathe in and out. And in and out. We're holding that extended table.
Okay. I don't want to kick my TV, so I'm coming this way. As we inhale, we bring that right arm, left arm towards the left side, right leg towards the right side. Exhale, bring it back to center. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe in. Breathe out. Hands on the mat. Woo! All right. Belly in towards the spine. As we inhale, our knees to hover about 2 inches off the mat. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And bring them down. Inhale, knees 2 inches above the mat. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Bring them down. Two more. Inhale, hover. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And bring them down. One more. Inhale, hover those knees above the mat. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And bring it down. One more. Inhale, hover. And as we exhale, we push through our hands with our knees bent, with our hips up. As we breathe in, we use the top of our thighs to push our legs straight. Don't lock the knees though. We want it straight, not past straight. And then as we exhale, we soften our heels towards the mat. Now they don't have to touch.
Mine aren't.
We just want to make sure we're going in that general direction. Take a big breath in and out. Big breath in and out. Now as we breathe in, we bend our knees, look forward to the top of our mat as we walk, step, skip, hop, jump to a forward fold. Find your blocks, find your books, whatever you need. Bend your knees. As we inhale, we bring our hands to our shins. We press our hearts forward for a halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, we come up vertebrae by vertebrae to a mountain pose. We turn that into a tall mountain pose, biceps by the ears. As we exhale, we bring our hands to the mat. We step it back for a nice high plank. Okay? We don't want to be too far forward. You know, we don't want our shoulders past our wrists, okay? Take a big breath in. Drop to your knees if that's your thing. If not, bend your elbows back. Chaturanga. Flip your toes into the mat. Push through your feet to lift your torso off the ground. Cobra, baby, cobra. Exhale as we come back to the mat.
Inhale as we go from low plank to high plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Pedal it out. Gonna do one more. Breathe in. Exhale, walk, step, skip, hop to the top of the mat. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, tall mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold, hands to the mat, step it back, high plank. Take a big breath in. Bend your elbows back, low plank. Inhale, cobra, baby cobra. Exhale, lower. Inhale, low plank to high plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe in. Walk, step, skip, hop to the top of your mat. Forward fold. And as we inhale, we come to a mountain pose. All right. So let's just make sure that we are standing strong in our mountain, standing tall in our mountain. So we breathe in, we bring our arms overhead for a tall mountain pose. And then we're gonna sit back to sit down for a chair pose. So instead of, we're gonna stick our butts out. And that's how we're gonna get down. Our knees will bend naturally if we stick our butts out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, hands to heart center. Big breath. Exhale as we twist to the right. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Inhale comes to heart center. Exhale as we twist to the left. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Inhale, hands to heart center. Exhale, forward fold, hands to the mat, step it back, high plank. Breathe in. Spread your fingers nice and wide on the mat, and then pull them towards one another. Really root where the thumb and the first finger meet, and then once you've got that together, pull them backwards towards you. Breathe in, and then bend your elbows back, chaturanga. Cobra, baby cobra. Exhale. Lowers. Inhale. Low to high plank. Exhale, downward. Facing dog. As we inhale, our right leg high towards the ceiling. And we exhale, we step our foot in between our hands for a low lunge. So you want to take that front heel and you want to root it into the mat, four corners of your feet, and you want to pull that heel back towards you, okay? You want to take that back knee and you want to pull that forward towards you. So we're pulling our heel and our knee kind of towards one another, even though we're kind of on different tracks here, okay? So hands on top of the thigh. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. And in and out. Pull your inner thighs towards one another. So really just like squeeze them towards each other, right? Now, we could stay here for a little bit, but if you want a little bit more, I invite you to go for the thigh stretch. So you're going to bring your heel, your back heel, towards your butt cheek, and then bring the shoulder up and back. And if it's like, I can't reach it, come forward a little bit. Then grab it, and then come back. So as you drag that front heel back, and you drag that back knee forward, you squeeze your thighs together and kick that foot into that ankle, ankle into the foot, like we did when we stood up, that's going to give you a nice stretch in the thigh. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and release. Find your, actually, walk that back knee back. And if you need it, go ahead and pad that knee. I thought I didn't need it today, but I did. Walk that knee back until you can root that heel into the mat. And then bow to your front knee for a half split. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Belly towards the spine. Breathe in. And as we return to the lunge or our exhale, inhale front. Knee meets the back knee. Exhale, hands towards the mat. Take a big breath in. Press it back up, downward dog. So that was the left side. We're going to do the right side next. For those of you who are keeping score. Inhale, right leg towards the ceiling. Toes dialed down. Keep your hips square. Step it through. Catch your lunge. Drop that back knee to a blanket. You can roll up your mat. Whatever you need to do to pad. Okay? Pulling that front heel, the right heel, back towards you. Pulling that back knee forward towards you. Squeezing your inner thighs together. Hands rest on top of the right thigh. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. If you want a little bit more, go ahead and bring that left heel towards the left butt cheek. Left shoulder goes up and back, grabs the ankle. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Whoa. Breathe in and release. Inhale brings front knee to meet the back knee. Exhale, hands towards the mat. Breathe in as we push through the inner edges of our hands through our knuckle pads, rooting the thumb and first finger into the mat. We press up, downward facing dog. Pedal it out. Before you come to stillness. Take a big breath in. As we raise our right leg towards the ceiling, we step it through to catch our runner's lunge. So let's get that 90-degree bend in our front leg. Hands to the mat. Once we got that together, let's get high on the ball of that back foot. And then once we got that together, we're going to pull that front heel back, push that back foot forward, squeezing our inner thighs together, and then we're going to come up for a crescent lunge. Breathe in and out. Breathe in as we reach up towards the ceiling. Exhale as we let the top of the right thigh to send. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. So we're in that crescent lunge, right? We walk that back foot in a little bit. Not a lot, just a little bit. As we inhale, we bring our knee to our chest. As we exhale, we walk it back nice and slow. Come back down for that lunge. Inhale, knee to chest. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, knee to chest. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, knee to chest. But this time, our left ankle is going to find the top of our right thigh. Going to guide that knee open. Breathe in. And as we exhale, we're going to sit back to sit down like we did in chair pose. Pigeon chair. Hey now. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Use that left elbow to guide that left knee more open. Breathe in and out. Breathe in, out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, knee in towards the chest. Exhale, throw it back. Airplane pose. If you're feeling kind of wobbly, that's okay. I am too. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale. Bring that knee in towards the chest. Exhale, walk it back to a crescent lunge. Breathe in, reach up. Exhale, hands frame the foot. Step it back. Downward facing dog. Notice how you feel. Take a big breath in. And out. Take a big breath in. And out. Inhale, lift that left leg up towards the ceiling. Exhale, steps it through to a runner's lunge. And as we come up for a crescent lunge, breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Walk your back foot in a little bit. Inhale. Right knee towards the chest. Exhale, walk it back. Inhale, knee in towards the chest. Exhale, walk it back. Inhale, knee in towards the chest. Exhale, walk it back. Inhale, knee in towards the chest. Now left ankle finds top of right thigh. Hands to heart center. As we sit back to sit down, pigeon chair. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in, out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, knee in towards the chest. Exhale, throw it back. Airplane pose. Hips square, toes dial down towards the mat as best you can. Breathe in and
out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in, out. Breathe in and out. Inhale. Knee in towards the chest. Exhale, step it back. Crescent lunge. Breathe in, reach up. Exhale. Handspring the foot. Step it back. Down dog. Pedal it out. And then come to stillness. Take a few breaths here. Now as we inhale, we're going to raise our left leg up towards the ceiling. Step it through to catch our lunge. Then we're going to dial our right foot in the same way of our right shoulder. And then we're going to cartwheel our arms up for warrior two. Take a big breath in and out. Take a big breath in. Out, big breath in, out, and in, and out. Inhale, flips the front palm, exhale, reverse the warrior. Breathe in, and out, breathe in, out, breathe in, and out. Breathe in and out and in and out. Inhale comes to warrior two. Exhale, left forearm comes on top of the left thigh. Now we're pushing the arm into the thigh into the arm. Okay, it's gonna give us some space. Open up towards the right shoulder. Right bicep frames the right ear. Stand side. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in, out. Breathe in and out. Inhale as we bring it back up to warrior two. Side out. Inhale, bends the front leg straight. Exhale, comes over for triangle pose. Now if you need to, find a block, find your goblet of fire. Put that block to the outside of your front shin. Triangle pose. Breathe in and out. Pull your belly in. Breathe in and out. Shoulders on the back. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Switch that block from the outside of your shin to the inside of your shin. Cartwheel your arms up. As you exhale, right hand comes to the inside of the left leg, revolve triangle. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale as we come up for warrior two. Exhale, we cartwheel the hands to frame the front foot. Step it back. Downward dog. Keep that block hand. Switch your sides. Right side. Inhale, lift that right leg up. Steps forward to catch your lunge. Dial your left foot to point in the direction of your left shoulder. As we cartwheel our arms up for warrior two. Now, if you did not get that 90 degree bend in your leg, right? You might have noticed that that was the case with me. Walk that leg back so the top of your left thigh, your right thigh rather, can get more towards the mat. Shoulders on the back, belly in. Head down over the second finger. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, flips the front palm. Exhale, reverse the warrior. Breathe in. Change nothing in the legs. Breathe out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, extended side. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, warrior two, side out. Inhale, bends the front leg straight. Find the block. Put it on the outside of your shin. Curl your arms up. Exhale. Hand to the block, hand to the mat. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. And in and out. Switch that block to the inside of the shin. Inhale, cartwheels the arms up. Exhale, left hand comes to the inside of the right foot, to the block, to the mat. Revolve triangle. Breathe in and out. And in and out. Breathe in and out. And in and out. Inhale as we cartwheel up for warrior two. Exhale, cartwheel the hands in front of the foot. Step it back, down facing dog. Woo. Breathe in, exhale, come down your knees. Find your water and take a drink. Before we do anything else. Take a couple breaths. Put your hand on your belly and make sure you send that breath all the way down. Breathe in and out. Put your right hand on your chest. Breathe in and out. And in and out. And in and out. Shake it out. Take the tongue off the roof of your mouth. Relax the muscles in your face. Maybe smile. If you want to, don't worry about it. Keep your face tight if that's what you need today. We're gonna come back down. Press it back up for downward facing dog. Big breath in. As we bring our hands to our feet to our hands in the middle of the mat. Inhale as we come up vertebrae by vertebrae for a mountain pose. Shake it. All right. So let's come to the ball of our right foot. Okay? So let's put that weight. Let's really root down. Let's get that power from our left foot as we start to stand on one foot again and kind of be off balance. We're going to take our right foot, and we're either going to bring it to the floor, our calf, or our inner thigh. So what we don't want is it being on our ankle or our knee. Muscles only, no joints. Okay? So we're going to bring it up. The point is to get that knee to open up and for us to stay forward. So it doesn't matter how high your foot is, okay? You're going to press that calf into that foot, that inner thigh into that foot, You're going to press that foot into that calf or inner thigh or the floor to give you a little more stability. But like I said, the point is to get this to open up. So it doesn't really matter. Breathe in and out. Tree pose. Breathe in and out. If you want to give that tree some branches, that's okay. Breathe in and out. They sway a little bit. That's what trees do. And in. They don't have to sway. You can stand strong. And out. It's all good. Breathe in. And hands to heart center. So we exhale. Inhale, pointing that knee forward. Exhale, bring that leg down. Shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out, out, out. All right. Okay. I'm going to come to the ball of that left foot. Okay. Now we're going to bring that foot to the floor, which is fine. You just want to get that hip to open up. You want to bring it to your ankle. It's fine too. Okay, we just want to make sure the rest of us is pointing forward and parallel. That's fine, you know? And if you want to bring it up to your thigh, that's cool too. I know for me, I have difficulty on this side getting on my inner thigh. Especially when I have like pants on, it just slips. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Maybe let you some branches and in and out and in and out. Inhale brings the knee forward. Exhale brings it down. All right. So I'm going to take our right thigh. I'm going to cross it over our left thigh, okay? So make sure you're squeezing them towards one another. Doesn't have to wrap all the way around, as long as those thighs are squeezing together. I'm going to take our right arm, we're going to put it underneath. So our shoulders on the back, so the palms can touch, the backs of the hands can touch, whatever you're going to do, and then sit back to sit down, like chair pose. For eagle pose. Breathe in and out. Breathe in. Stick your butt out and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale. Unravel knee towards the chest. Bring it down. Shake it out. Come to the ball of the left foot. And then wrap your left thigh around your right thigh. Really squeeze them towards one another. And then take that left arm, put it under, sit back, sit down, stick your butt out like chair pose. For eagle pose. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale, brings the knee up, unravels yourself, bring it down. Inhale, reach way up high towards the ceiling. Exhale, forward fold. Breathe in. And as we breathe out, we come down to our knees, and then come down to our bellies. Hands clasped together, like a kid watching TV. And then just move your hips from side to side. Make your left hand parallel to the short side of your mat. Or you can see. And then Bring your right heel towards your right butt cheek and bring your right shoulder up and back till you can grab that ankle. And then come up on that left forearm just enough so that you feel the stretch in the thigh. Kick that ankle, flex that foot, kick that ankle to that hand, hand to that ankle. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale and release. Inhale, switch to sides. Make your right arm parallel to the short side of your mat. Bring your left heel towards your left butt cheek. Left shoulder up and back. Kick that hand to that ankle. Push that ankle into that hand. Come up on that right forearm just enough. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and release. Clasp your hands together again. Inhale as we come to our knees. Exhale, we send the right leg back like we're in forearm plank. Breathe in. We send the left leg back like we're in forearm plank. Lower the hips. Now your forearm plank, four breaths, belly towards the spine, thighs towards the sky. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and release. As we roll over to come on our back. Now, yogi's choice. Now you can do a supported bridge. Get that block right underneath that sacrum, right? Or you can do a bridge without support, or you can go full wheel. So we're going to do three, and I'll show you each one. So we'll do supported bridge first, and you can stay here if you like. If you already know how to do bridge without the support of the block, go ahead and do it. Push through the feet, come on up. Shoulders on the back, if you're using a block. Elbows on the mat, palms facing towards each other, like little robot arms. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. If you're using the block and want to remove it, go ahead and push through your feet to remove the block. Shoulders on the back to give you a little more lift. Breathe in. Exhale as we come to our backs. Now, if you want to step it up to regular bridge without support, make sure those feet are parallel, pointing forward. Breathe in. And as you exhale, push through your feet to lift your hips up. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And lower. So for those of you who want to do full wheel, I'm going to have to face this way so I don't knock over my television set. All right. So feet forward. As we press, we exhale, we press our hips up towards the ceiling. We get into a regular bridge. Then we place our hands wider than we think we might need to. As we push through our, breathe in, push through your feet some more to maybe get to the crown of your head. And then line your hands and your feet up. Make sure they're parallel. Breathe in and push through your feet to get to full wheel. Breathe in and out. Belly towards the spine. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale. Exhale. So we come to the crown of our head and then come down.
Knock your knees in towards one another. Take a big breath in. As you exhale, windshield wiper your legs back and forth. And next time they fall to the right, let them stay there. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. And in. And out. Inhale brings it to center. Exhale brings it to the left. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. And in. And out. And in. And out. Inhale, bring it in towards the center. Side out. Inhale, bring your knees in towards your chest. And as you exhale, extend your left leg long and keep your right knee in towards your chest. Take a big breath in. And as you exhale, bring your right leg over to the left side. Breathe in.
In her church,
and out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Inhale. Brings it back to center. Exhale. Switches sides. Left knee in towards the chest. Right leg long. Take a big breath in. We use our right hand to guide our left knee over to the right side. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Inhale as we come to center. Exhale, bring those knees in towards our chest. And then make some nice circles on your lower back on the mat. Give yourself a nice little massage. And as we inhale, we come to happy baby. And just go from side to side. One sec. Go to happy baby as we come from side to side. Inhale, we bring our knees to our chest. As we do three gentle rocks to a comfortable seat. And now we're getting ready for final rest, Shavasana. So first of all, take some water if you need it. And then we're gonna get ready to rest for a few minutes here. So go ahead and find your blanket or your blocks, whatever you feel like you need in order to be able to, you know, go into final rest. I like a good heart bench. That might not be for you. You can lay your head on the block. Whatever works for you. You can cover yourself up. All right. So
Welcome back. For those of you on Instagram Live that got booted off. So we're going to come to final rest. And just lay back. The work, as they say, is over for now. Slowly bring yourself back to wherever it is you went. Maybe bring some life to your fingers and your toes. Maybe make some circles with your wrists or your ankle. And as you come to, as you start to feel connected again, give yourself a nice, great, big, good morning stretch. Complete with sounds and everything as we wake up for the second time today. Big breath in. And as we exhale, we come to a fetal position. Right side, left side, makes no difference. Take a big breath in. Sigh it out. Big breath in. Sigh it out. Inhale. Use your strong arms to push yourselves back up to a comfortable seat. Let's bring our hands to heart center as we end our time together with three cleansing breaths. Take a big breath in. Out through the nose. Take a big breath in. Out through the nose. Take a big breath in. Hold it. Sigh out nice and loud. Ha. So we open our eyes. Light me. Honors the light in each and every one of you. Thank you so much for being here. I thank you. Namaste. Thanks a lot, guys. Don't forget, donations can be sent to Roots to Rise, to Venmo at Roots to Rise, our Facebook page, so Facebook/Roots to Rise, or RootsToRise.com. Whatever you can donate would be great. Thank you so much. I'll see you next week.
I'm so glad. How are you? How's everything? I told you.